Okay everyone, today I will show you how to set up a personal cloud media server. To set up the server, we'll first need to install Jellyfin. Next, you're going to need your own domain name and have access to change your name servers. We'll then need to set up our Cloudflare account and create a tunnel. With this server, you can stream your own videos, music, and view your own photos, just like this. As you can see here, I've created three separate folders. Here's a photos folder, here's a videos folder, and here is a music folder. Now, the great part of having your own personal media server is that you're hosting your own data stored on your own PC or laptop that you own. If you take lots of photos and record videos with your smartphone, tablet, digital camera, etc., you can offload that data to your PC server, freeing up space on your devices. You will soon see how to access your data from anywhere in the world using a domain name that you own. Using any browser, you'll simply enter your domain name, log in with your credentials, and view your data. You will also have the ability to download your data from any PC or app as well. You can install the Jellyfin app for Android, iOS, and many others. Don't forget to check out our description below for timestamps and some products that we recommend. So let's get started. Okay everyone, we're gonna do a complete Jellyfin server installation starting from scratch. So first thing you wanna do is go to your browser, type in Jellyfin, look for jellyfin.org, click on it, go to download now, click on that. We're gonna install the Windows version, so scroll all the way down, click on all versions, click on stable, click on installer, and then click the latest version 10.8.5, and then click .exe, and then save it. Once it's finished downloading, click it, select yes, click next, scroll down for the agreement, I agree, leave it on basic install, recommended. Install folder, I'm gonna leave it as default. Data folder, I'm gonna leave it as default. Here's the summary confirmation page. Click install. Once it has completed installation, click close. Close your browser. What we want to do now is open up the server. So you can open it up in two different ways. You can search for it right here and just type in Jellyfin and then look for the Jellyfin tray app. You can also go to start, Jellyfin tray app. We're just going to use the search button. Jellyfin, click Jellyfin tray app. It's going to run in the taskbar in the background. So what you're going to want to do is right click it. Make sure that it says start Jellyfin. Click open Jellyfin. Once you open up your Jellyfin server, you should come to a page like this. Select your language. Click next. Create a username. I'm just going to leave it as BC. Create your password. Click next. It's asking to set up our media files. So we're going to do this later. Click next. Select your preferred metadata language. I'm going to leave mine as default. Click next. Set up remote access. Make sure to allow remote connections to the server. Make sure this is checked. You can leave the enable automatic port mapping unchecked. Click next. So now that we're done, click finish. Now it should take you to the sign in page. So you're gonna wanna log in with your credentials that you previously created. So just log in, click sign in, and here we are. We have officially installed Jellyfin server. As you can see, there's nothing here yet. If you were to click on the menu right here, scroll down to dashboard, you will see all the details of your host computer information. This is where you can add your libraries, meaning your media files and your folders, where your movies, photos, music is located. And these are your playback options. So our next video, I'm gonna show you some troubleshooting tips if you're having any issues setting up this server. Now you might come across an issue when you're trying to start your server. So here's a troubleshooting tip. The problem that you might have is when you try to click on your server and you connect to it, it's gonna bring up this error. So the way to get around it is just come down here, go to search, type in CMD, click it, type in ipconfig, enter, grab your IPv4 address, copy it. Now go and click server, click in the host, paste the address, and then right here where it shows your port number, add that in. So add :8096, click connect. And then from here you can log in. So enter your credentials, sign in, and here we are back to your server. Now what's gonna happen is that you created another server that's the same name. So if you come down here again, click menu, sign out, click the reload page, you're gonna see that you have two of the same servers. This is the one that you couldn't connect to. You see how we just try to connect to it and it says this, but we created another one by troubleshooting, and this is the one that works. So you just simply just click on the one that wasn't working, just delete it. And then this is the one that this is your server, which once you log in, you're gonna have this running at all times. So this is the computer that will host all your media, and then we can connect to it. Okay, everyone. So when it comes to adding anything regarding your media, whether it's books, movies, photos, or music, the process is pretty straightforward. There's two ways to add your media. You can either click right here or come up here to the top left and select Dashboard. Next, select Libraries. Click Add Media Library. So we're going to start off with movies, and you can just leave everything right here and then click Folders. This is where your path will show up. This is where you click to search within your C drive. So my movie folders is located under Users, BC, Desktop. Your path may be different, but you just need to know where you store your media files. So once you have it selected, click OK. Library settings, I'll choose English. Leave everything else by default, click OK. Next, we'll add our photos. Content type, select photos. We'll leave the display name photos. We'll click folders again. This will be your path. Click C drive. Again, we'll look for the photos folder. So in my case, it's on the desktop as well. Click OK. Once you verify the path, click OK. For photos, I'm just going to leave everything by default. Click OK. And there we have it. We added it right here. So to view your directory, just come back here to home. And then here we go. You can click on it and view your media like this. You can play it. You can also skip to the next one. You can go back, view your photos. And there we go. So adding your directories it's a pretty straightforward process. Okay, everyone. I'm going to show you how to find the best price for a domain name on GoDaddy here. So when it comes to a domain name for your server, the name really doesn't matter. So for example, we'll just type in any domain name we can think of right now. Let's just say, for example, we use the name time to get a new domain name, and then click search. Let's see what comes up. So we're going to scroll down here, and what we're looking for is obviously the cheapest domain name, but we're wanting to get one that has the description right here, like it says right here, for the first year. So when you see this price, this is what you're actually going to pay for 1 year only. And just to see what else is out there. No, that one looks like the best price. Everything else is either a 2 year minimum. So this one might say one penny, but then the next year it might be, you know, up to $20, just for example. So we're going to go with this one because this one is by far the cheapest. So if you click here, we're going to add it to our cart, go up to your cart. Just for the example, we're going to sign in later. So because we're not creating a website, we don't really need any of this extra stuff. So we're just going to select no domain protection, uncheck start your website for free, and make sure this is clicked no thanks, continue to cart. So right here, it's going to show 2 years. We're just going to select one as the first year promotion. And look at that, 99 cents for one full year. Now, if you continue using your server using the same domain name, this one, for example, you can always just set your renewal to auto renewal or just let it cancel. But either way, it's going to cost you 99 cents for one domain for the year. And then we're going to use this domain name as a way to access your server. So there you go. Now you know how to find the best price for your domain name. Okay, everyone, we're going to create our Cloudflare account. So it's pretty simple. Just enter your email address and create a password. And then to create a password, just follow these instructions they lay out right here. And then once you have that, click sign up. Okay, so once you're logged in, you're going to be at the home page right here. Go to websites on your left, click websites, and then right here where it says you currently don't have any websites, click add site. At the accelerate and protect your site with Cloudflare page, right below here where it says enter your site, just click in there, enter your website name. As you can see, I just added an example, but enter your domain name that you got from GoDaddy. If you have an existing domain name that's from another registrar other than GoDaddy, just enter it where it says enter your site. And then in the following steps that we're going to do, you just need to access your registrar's website and find where you can change the name servers. Later on, I'm going to show you how to access GoDaddy's name servers. But in your case, if you're using someone else other than GoDaddy, just make sure you have access to their site and go ahead, sign in and find out where the name servers are. And you're going to need to replace the name servers in your registrar's website with Cloudflare's name servers. Once you add your domain name, click add site. After adding your site, scroll all the way down and select the free account right here, and then click continue. After clicking continue, you're going to come to a page, add more DNS records. Scroll right down here, scroll down and click continue. When it says add records later, just click confirm. So right here, we're at the name server page where it's asking you to log into your registrar where your domain name is hosted. So for example, if you purchased your domain name from GoDaddy, you're going to want to log into GoDaddy as the administrator, and then go into your name servers, and then we're going to replace the name servers that are listed on GoDaddy. We're going to replace them with these ones right here. So I'm going to show you how to do that right now. Okay, everyone, I'm going to show you how to access your name servers on your GoDaddy account. So the first thing you want to do is log into your GoDaddy account, click on the upper right, and then select My Products. Once you select My Products, scroll down a bit until you reach your domain name right here, and then select DNS. After selecting DNS, scroll down a bit until you get to Name Servers. Click on Update. Once you get to Edit Name Servers page right here, go all the way down right here and click on Enter My Own Name Servers. When you reach Edit Name Servers, this is where you're going to erase the existing name servers that are in here. You're going to go into your Cloudflare account and grab those name servers and then add them here. And I'm going to show you how to grab those name servers from Cloudflare, and then you're going to bring them into this page right here. And then once you enter the name servers from Cloudflare to this location in your GoDaddy name server account, once you enter those two name servers, click Save, and then you should see your name servers updated right here. Once you click Save, you're going to see your new name servers listed right here. Make sure that these name servers are identical to the Cloudflare name servers. Once you've reached this point, you are pretty much set up with the GoDaddy account. So to get to the name server page on cloudflare.com, just log in, click on Websites, go to your domain name that you're going to add, click on it. Once you click on it, you're going to see two areas to access your DNS servers, your name servers. You can either click right here on your left-hand side where it says DNS, or over here where it says DNS settings. So for this example, just click on DNS settings. And once you get here, scroll down and you're going to see Cloudflare name servers. Take these name servers and then add them to your GoDaddy name server account and replace it with these ones. And it doesn't matter which order you put these in. You can put them in any order. As long as these go into the GoDaddy account, then you're good. Once you're finished changing your name servers, come down to this page right here and click Done, Check Name Servers. The next thing we're going to do is set up the quick start guide. So as you can see, there's three steps right here. So first thing you do is just click Get Started. Automatic HTTPS rewrites, just leave that selected and click Save. Always use HTTPS, make sure that's checked, click Save. Auto Minify, make sure these are all checked, click Save. Broadly, make sure it's checked, click Save. Review the summary and make sure that it matches just like this, and then click Finish. Okay, once you click Finish, it's going to take you to the overview page. Now my site has already been active, so it's saying that my site is being protected. Yours may still say pending, so just give it some time. After you give it some time, click on Cloudflare up here on the top. Once you get here, click Websites, and then make sure that your website shows active. Once it shows active, come down here to the left and click on Zero Trust. Okay, now we're in the Zero Trust part of Cloudflare. You should be at the page where it says Welcome Aboard. First thing we got to do is set up your gateway locations. So click right here on Gateway, go to Locations and select Locations. Click on Add Location. Give your location a name, anything you want, and then click on Update to Current User IP. Now, it's going to use your current IP address. If you're using a VPN, it's going to use that address. And then select Set as Default Location. So once you've updated this and checked this, click Add Location. It's going to show you your information right here. Just leave everything alone as is, and then click Done. Now here you can add more locations, but you don't really need to. You just need one to get your server to work. Next thing you want to do after setting up your gateway location is come over back to this page on your left hand side, click Access. It's going to bring this drop down menu right here. Click Tunnels. Once you click Tunnels, click Create a Tunnel. Give your tunnel any name and then click Save Tunnel. Make sure you're choosing your right environment. So if we're using Windows, so I'm going to leave Windows selected and 64-bit. So we're going to first install a connector. So the first thing to do is just download by clicking this link right here. So click this link. You're going to see it download a .msi file down below. Click on that. If this window pops up, just click on More Info. Click Run Anyway. Once you click Run Anyway, the app is going to install and then run in the background. So the first thing to do is click right here in your search bar, type in CMD, go to Command Prompt, right click, and then Run as Administrator. So what we're doing is we're at step number 3 right now. So the next thing is to run the following commands. So right here, what you want to do is click right here to copy it. So we're going to copy this. We're going to bring back your command prompt, click in there, and then paste this command in there like so. Once you paste it in, press enter. After hitting enter, you should see this installation was installed successfully like so. Once you see that it has been installed successfully, just exit out the window. After exiting command prompt, come back here to your left-hand side. If it hasn't been selected, just click access. Come back down here to tunnels, and you should see this page right here. Come over here to the right, click on configure, click on public host name, click on add a public host name. Come over here to domain where it says required and select your domain name. Come back here to type, select HTTP. Next, we're gonna get the URL. To get the URL, we gotta go back to search. Again, type in CMD, just click command prompt to open it. Once it's open, type in ipconfig and then hit enter. Okay, what we're looking for is your IPv4 address. Now in my case, my Wi-Fi is on the Wi-Fi 2 network. Yours may be a different one. Either way, I'm gonna select this right here. This is the IP address we gotta grab. So highlight it and then copy it. And then we're gonna paste that IP address right here. After pasting the IP address, come back down here to your search bar again, type in Jellyfin Tray app. Click it right here. It's gonna open up in the bottom right of your tray. Right click it and then click on open Jellyfin. So the reason why we're gonna open up Jellyfin is we wanna verify that you're using the right port number. So in my case, my port number is the number just after localhost colon. And then mine is 8096. So take 8096 and then we're gonna paste it after the IP address that we put in earlier. So just to clarify this, we put in our IP address from the command prompt. We typed in colon after that and then entered our port number. After entering it in as this example, just click outside the box right here and then this service URL is not valid, should disappear just like this. Once all this information is entered, you don't have to worry about this right now, the subdomain and the path. Just make sure that your domain, your URL, and your type has been filled in. And then click Save Hostname. After clicking on Save Hostname, you should see right here underneath your public hostname, you should see your domain name right here. Obviously, I blurred mine out, but yours should be right here. And it should be connected to your IP address with the port number under the service. So the next thing to do is just click on it. And once you click on it, it should take you right here to your server login page. Once you're here, just enter your username and password and then click sign in. So in my case, I signed into my home server. So this is what I'm seeing. You should see something similar if you've already added some of your media libraries. So in my case, I have 3 media libraries right here. Photos, video, and music. These are all from free sources. So this is obviously from YouTube audio. They have a free list of audio songs and Pexel videos and Pexel photos. And as you can see right here, under dashboard, libraries, here are the path of where these folders were located. So if you go back to home, you can view your photos like so. Now, right now I am viewing my server locally, but this could easily be my domain name that we just set up. Now you might be wondering why I'm not showing my domain name, but that's just for privacy reasons. Other than that, this might as well be my domain name because it would work because it's linked through the tunnel. So in your case, in your example, you should see your domain name right here. And then you'll be able to access this information from your cell phone or from your friend's computer. Just give him your domain name and he should see the same thing you're seeing right here. So there you go. Now you have your server where you can access it from anywhere you want. And if you start adding more videos and files, you can always just add them right here under libraries and just keep adding your files. And enjoy.